Hello, this is Gary from Gary Keep It Simple. Today is a momentous day for the channel. We got our first 50 subscribers all signed up. On Saturday, Recordology gave me a shout out for my channel, and I'd like to say thank you very much. Thank you, thank you, thank you. It made such a difference. Now, if you don't know who Recordology is, go and have a look at his channel. It's really good. He's got equipment, he's got information, he's got music, and he's keen and he's lovely. It's the sort of show that makes you have a smile to start the day. Got the results of the tests on the Teac W1200, which some of you have been waiting for. But people are interested in it, it's the results I've got and clarification on a couple of bits. So you don't want to miss that. So we're looking here at the trace, the Audacity trace of the white noise. It's fairly normal as you'd expect, nice sharp edge on the end, and that's how the recorder was fed. Now what we're going to do is we're going to look over at the output of the recorder in a few seconds and you can see what the differences are. Here's a really nice way to do this actually, here we go. Now looking at that you can see why the specification may be what it is, because at around about the 12.5 kHz, that's where you've got your dB points. However, if you look, the slope does not drop like a stone, it's a nice taper. So this is what we've got to expect. On my previous video, I used the traces from Audacity to show the frequency response on the burst at the end. This is from a different app. This is a Type 1 ferric. This is the Maxell XV. In my original video on the frequency response, I used an analog input, and this is a trace of what the analog input looks like. As you can see, it's got a few dips and craters and bumps and lumps, so it's not particularly good in that respect because it imposes that upon the results it gets. On the other hand, if you're looking at this, this is the noise floor from the digital input, and I think you can see it's pretty good. Just a little bit of a glitch there, about 13 kHz. And now we can have a look at the results. We've got some Type 2 tape. This trace is from a different app called Advanced Spectrum Analyzer Pro, and it's a very good Android app. In much the same way as the Audacity app showed it, this is showing again a nice smooth roll off to 22 kHz. And now we're looking at the frequency burst for the Type 2 tape, which is being shown on the Android app, but is from the Audacity generated tones. And as you can see, it goes up to 18.358 kHz before it sort of disappears. This is an interesting one. This is tape, Type 1 tape noise, with and without the noise reduction on. So you can see the noise reduction has, around about 10 dB effect, depending on exactly what part of the spectrum you're looking at. And this one is the same figures for the Type 2. Again, very similar trace, just the actual numbers are different. And this is the difference between the Type 1 and the Type 2, just as it's sat there playing. The figures are over superimposed with each other, so you can see there's a genuine difference between the Type 1 and Type 2, no noise reduction. Before anybody asks, just to let you know, this was recorded on a digital recorder using the output, the USB output from the Teac tape deck, and the figures are reproducible, and if anybody wants to query them, fine, I can answer any queries. If you've got any comments, put them in the comments section. Don't forget to like, subscribe, share, all that sort of good stuff. And I hope you enjoyed this. Hope it means something to you. And I'll catch you another time. Cheers. Bye.